Mark Zero's XCOM The Long War. Let's play.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to The Long War. I am Mark Zero, and we are currently mid-mission on the Newfoundland site recon. We are actually mid-turn. We just took out a Chrysalid. So for those of you who have come back from the previous episode, welcome back. If you did not see the previous episode, go back one episode and watch the beginning of the mission. If you truly object to the way that I have laid out this mission format, please comment below and let me know. But yeah, we are going to keep on keeping on. So the mission so far, just as a quick recap, we started at the LZ over here. We worked our way across this dock, and we've dealt with a significant amount of contact. Much of the contact on the map at this point has been dealt with. With the exception of the objective area over here. So we are going to, in this episode, sweep up here and clear the wharf and clear the fishery area over here just to make sure that there's nothing left for us to deal with. Then we will be advancing on the target. Alrighty, and in fact... Well, we should be good. I was going to say I should save my game, but you know what? We'll live dangerously. So let's see. We used up Sean Devlin's turn. Now we want to begin collapsing in this direction. So let's start moving this way and setting up our overwatches. We want to get... I think we can get TS to here on overwatch, so that's a better idea than running Drew.
Roger that. Scanning.
Our team, by the way, if you don't know... Drew Smith, T.S. Moth, Peter Van Dorn, Sean Devlin. We have Neith posted up way up on a rooftop. I'm going to have to move him soon. And the Rev back in action for the first time in quite a while.
Moving.
And Hrothgar, who has taken a little bit of battle damage. Hrothgar will be in the med bay for a little while. Actually tempted to drop Rev back.
On my way.
To get like a little bit of a better firing angle for rockets, since rockets are pretty much gonna be what we're resolving ourselves to soon.
Hey, do you hear something?
Yeah, we did hear something. Can't tell if that was Thin Man or not. Might have been. I think we're gonna wanna put Neith up where Sean Devlin is. Pretty soon. Alright. Well, Sean...
I'm rolling.
Let's get you to here. So you can start to rejoin the rest of the crew here. And what we're gonna do, I think, is we're gonna come up this staircase in the middle so that we have a good chance at getting up to where we need to be. And in fact, at this point, I am going to blow the battle scanner and see if we have any contact. Well, maybe not yet. I'd like to get a little bit closer and then throw the battle scanner. Really not sure if I want to keep Neith where he is or... start moving him forward.
I'm on it, Commander.
Alright. Steady that rocket. We'll come to this decision in a minute. Now, I could put Van Dorn up here, but I'm not going to. I'm going to put Van Dorn over here.
Approaching target now.
And on Overwatch.
We have eyes on the target.
Drew. Let's move Drew up to here. Tempted to take the dreaded double move. Now, I don't want to put my back to here because here's where we heard the contact. I'm actually going to just stay where I am in Overwatch. Drew. Yeah, Overwatch is fine. Steady it. I'm going to keep you where you are for the moment. And let's put Sean into the thick of the action. Okay, good. I always get nervous when I do that last gold move. Like, oh, this is a bad idea. But we're all right. Hrothgar can't get too far. Hrothgar is probably going to hang back when we move into the ship. I know people suggested on the Reddit that I opened up about doing the box strat. I've never done the box strat. I'm not comfortable with doing the box strat now. I'm thinking that we don't.
I'm on the move.
Alright, let's throw a battle scanner up here and see if we got anything in this general area.
Scanner's up and running.
If we don't, we can go up this staircase with impunity. Okay, nothing there. So what I'm thinking is we go up this staircase with impunity, and the last thing that we really need to clear is this wharf area here. I think that the zombies may have just come from here straight to us, but I want to be sure before we activate the last part of the mission.
Roger, correct.
Alright, let's take the fateful yellow move. Okay, clear. Put TS. Let's see. We want Van Dorn in a position where he can get an effective overwatch.
Affirmative.
I'm thinking over here. Eyes
on the target.
Drew, we're gonna move over here to breach up the other staircase. Rev.
Moving.
You're gonna move up and cover Sean. Let's get a steady weapon. And TS, you're gonna run thinking up to here.
Target confirmed. On our
so
way.
We can get you into a good position next turn. You and Sean will sweep forward.
Hello?
We have a zombie on our flank. So we should be aware of that. We have a zombie on our flank. As opposed to having a zombie on our lawn.
Roger that.
Let's see what we can see over here. Clear. Clear. Okay, we may have no contact up here. It's beginning to look that way. It looks like we have no contact. So, let's start repositioning towards the ship. I think we've cleared the map. I am okay with a boring start to this this episode's worth of the mission. So now, we want to think about breaching the ship. Now here's the thing. We can breach up into the ship via, I believe there's a pole over here. I think Drew is my fastest soldier right now. So what I think we're going to do is we're going to check for this zombie, and once it's down, I'm going to start moving Drew towards the top of the ship.
In motion! We have eyes on the target.
We're not going to box strat the Chrysalids, though. We're going to just take them down one by one as they come out. And get out of dodge as fast as we can. I think that's the... I'm thinking this over in my head now, because what we could also do is we could install Neath up here. And we could just take the Chrysalids down from the top. That might be what we do. Still kind of like mulling over the options in my head of how we're going to handle this.
Let's do this.
Let's move Hrothgar up. I think it's time to dislodge Neath. One zombie isn't worth keeping the sniper all the way up there. Even though he would technically have visual all the way over there. But
heading there now.
Keeping the squad together is a better idea in my opinion. Alright. Let's get the Rev forward.
On the move.
Start regrouping the squad.
That ship didn't just run aground.
It looks like it was overrun. I'd say that's the likely source of our chrysalid problem.
I would agree with you, Bradford.
Thankful it wasn't a cruise liner.
What do we got? Oh, hey, he was behind us the whole time. Sneaky monkey. Alright. TS Moth has two shots. Who else might be able to get a shot on this thing? We could get Rev up there. We get Hrothgar to provide a little holo targeting? Unlikely. Okay. Well, let's do what we can with TS. Good. And that should be... done and done. Okay, great. So... we can either do one of two things. We can hole up out here and cover Drew as she runs up and hits the button. That's the way I've always done this, is I hole up over here and I just attack the chrysalids as they come out. The other option is everybody gets up here and we do like the box strat on the whale and we farm out the chrysalids before we hit the button. I think I go with what I know, dangerous as it may be. I'm gonna go with what I know here. Oh, Sean Devlin was up here. Neat. Alright, so, Drew. Actually, Rev. Well, Rev's got two rockets left. We're gonna need those.
Affirmative.
Nah, I probably should have gone on the roof. I still can go on the roof. I'm gonna go on the roof. Okay, good. No activation in the inside. Hrothgar.
Affirmative.
I'm gonna go here. Sean Devlin. You've got the AP grenades, so it's going to be your job to cover. Drew, you are in the unenviable position of being the runner.
Multiple incoming hostiles.
That's not really multiple incoming hostiles, it's one. Cool. Four damage is four damage. I don't think he can get to you. But just in case he can.
Closing on target.
We'll do this.
We have eyes on the target.
Roger.
And we'll do this. And we'll set up for the final push. Let's let this guy come out and get put down. This must have been the other zombie that we were just hunting. Come on. Come on out. Van Dorn wants to speak to you. Oh, you little pain in the neck. Alright, well, we know who he's going after. He's going after Rev. What do we got for a shotgun blast on this guy? Pretty good one. One hit point. Rev, if you could please do me a favor. And remove this guy. Thank you.
Taken care of.
Alright. Hrothgar overwatches. Neath steadies.
End for that location.
Sean Devlin, work your way down.
Locked and loaded.
Alright. TS, you need to get into position. I don't really need to worry too much about getting into cover at this point. TS is gonna need to take a reload though before the fun starts.
Sir.
Yep. Let's get into position over here. Get over watching.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
Watching. Oh, okay. So yeah, we've definitely cleared all the contact.
Heading out.
All right. Now, we don't want to start taking gold moves until we're damn good and ready here.
Moving.
And I'm even going to go ahead and take a reload on the carbine. And I'll take a reload on the sniper rifle. I'm just going to generally reload anybody who needs a reload.
On my way. Ready to rock.
That's a reload.
Closing on target.
This is my main Overwatch. Alright.
Okay.
Let's stay on this corner. And I'm thinking we even put Sean over here. And let's take a reload on the pistol.
Locked and loaded.
Alright. Now life gets pretty simple. We are going to activate some problems.
I'm on it, Commander.
How close can we get?
I'd say we found the source of our infestation. But this is worse than we could have imagined. If the Chryssalids are using that whale as some sort of hive, who knows how many offspring they could produce?
Many. It is a Chryssalid orgy in there.
Strike one. Our sensor readings are picking up a whole lot of activity from inside the hold of that ship. I think you're about to have a lot of company headed your way. Nothing you've got on hand is going to be enough for this one. What we need is an airstrike. If you can reactivate that ship's transponder, we can have air support pinpoint your location and take the whole thing out.
We gotta nuke it from orbit. It's the only way to be sure. Alright, so now the fun begins. So, the Chryssalids, we've just disturbed the, Chryssalid happy sexy time party going on in that whale. We are going to get shitloads of Chryssalids coming out now. Now, hopefully they're not going to try to jump up top and catch Drew. Who is now, her job is to run for this transponder. Everybody else's job is to basically stand here and fight Chryssalids. And in fact, to entice said Chryssalids into coming down and saying hello, Sean,
affirmative.
I would like you to be bait.
Scanning.
Eyes on the prize.
Got eyes on the target.
Alright. Steady your weapon.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
And steady your weapon. Here comes the fun. Chryssalid one. Let's keep track if we can. It's gonna get overwhelming fast. So we can get up to the transponder in one move.
Location confirmed.
Here we go. And steady weapon.
Eyes on the prize.
Steady weapon.
I see the commander.
Eyes on the target.
Let's see where they come. Here's the first one. Sean. Why do you have your pistol out, Sean?
Who's the target?
Oh boy, I don't like the way he's moving. No, here he comes. Come on. Take him out. One, two. Cool.
He's moving down there.
Alright. There's the second one. We could technically farm them from out here, but I am a little worried about Drew getting jumped on up here. So, here we go.
The ship's transponder is active and transmitting. You need to get moving, Strike One. That whole place is going up in a matter of minutes, and anyone left behind is as good as dead.
8 turns to get out of dodge.
No objective received.
8 turns and only 8 turns to get out of dodge. So, I'm actually not going to take the jump down. I'm going to take a run across the ship.
Solid copy, Commander.
And back down the ramp. And I want to try to keep Drew in sight of the rest of the squad. Keep it steady. Keep it steady. Sean, now's your cue to kind of start pulling back.
Understood.
You're gonna receive Drew on the other side of the ship. Anybody else? You're still on Overwatch duty, guys. Okay. Now we know that they're spawning in there. Can we get through? Is this pathable? Yes, it is. But I can also get down here and then back with the squad. Way. Okay, we're doing that. Drop down, run across, and back with the squad. Excellent. Okay, now we start collapsing back.
Heading to that location.
We're going to do something of a phased retreat, but at this point, I no longer care about killing anything at all. The important thing is to keep the squad together and get out of Dodge. Now, since we didn't really clear up here, I'm going to stick to this dockway down here and then up at the end. That's the plan. Let's see. Hrothgar is the biggest concern.
10-4.
Because Hrothgar is going to have the lowest movement. Let's see. We can put Neith here and steady before we start running all out with Neith. And let's see. Rev is going to overwatch. TS is going to, I'm thinking, come back to here because we want to keep Drew covered until Drew can take the next major, like, big run out of here. And we're going to do a shotgun overwatch from here. Here comes the fun.
What's making that noise?
I don't think they can get up to us in one turn. Good. Even just wounding them, because of the red fog, wounding them will inhibit their ability to get up to us. So any Overwatch shots that hit are just icing on the cake right now. Alright, we're gonna need to, like, kind of flat-out run, but we don't want to flat-out run without some Overwatch protection. Sean, can you hit him? Good. Alright. So Drew needs to get out. Drew's primary objective now is run as far as he can. She can. Let's see. Do we have a shot with an infantry? We do. 75 to hit. You can shoot and move. There we go. Good riddance indeed. Now move as far as you can. Which means Van Dorn.
Affirmative.
To here and to Overwatch.
We have eyes on the target.
Drew goes here.
Let's do this.
Alright, that is the far contact. Now, I could throw a grenade over, but honestly, we don't want to get bogged down. We truly do not want to get bogged down right now.
I'm on the move. Run back. Scanning.
Hrothgar.
Running.
Move it. And at this point, Neith.
De acuerdo.
All the way back. Cool. Sean.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
Take the front. Alright. Take him out. It's a miss.
No joy here.
This one better not be close enough. Nope. He's not. Okay. At this point, I'm not even counting. It's just a full-on sprint to the finish. In fact, I might just gold move everybody, if I can. We're gonna get another one. We got... Okay, that one's a concern. That one's a legitimate problem. One that Hrothgar may be able to solve. That helps. Alright, Neith has an 89 to hit. Sean Devlin can confirm the kill with a grenade.
Position confirmed.
Alright, we're almost there. Let's confirm this kill with a grenade. Actually, how's the shotgun blast? 60? That's not terrible. Well, we can snapshot, so let's move up. How's the snapshot look? 79, 69.
Heading there now.
Drew can confirm with an HE grenade. Or Drew can just gold move out. TS, please give up all of your shots in favor of getting out of there. Van Dorn, possibly the same. Rev, definitely give up your shots to move. Okay. Neith, finish it off. Good. Alright, Sean Devlin. You're going to secure the LZ. Van Dorn, honestly...
In motion!
What's your shot? 56? Drew, you're moving up as well. Don't know if he can get there or not. I don't know if he can get there, and I don't want to risk it.
Approaching target now.
Get out of the way. I don't think he can get all the way up in one turn. Good. Hi, buddy. Want to come with us? Do you want to come be the new XCOM pet? Yeah? Is that what you want? Be the new XCOM pet? Because, No, I don't think you will. I think...
Confirmed. Weapons empty. Can't engage.
Yeah, that's all right.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Moving on out. Alright, so that unfortunately means we gotta leave somebody on the dock. But...
Moving out.
We're almost out. Let's see. Let's move Neith to here. Sean Devlin can hit the end zone, like, already. So I think we just gotta survive one more turn.
In motion.
Van Dorn, you're gonna cover.
We have eyes on the target.
Hrothgar.
Location confirmed.
Up as far as you can. Yeah, just a nice quick run out of here. why I'm overwatching, because it doesn't make much sense.
I'm on it, Commander. Eyes peeled, Commander.
Alright, we're probably going to see one more Chrysalid, but I think we can get out of here in time. Yep, pop. We probably could have done the box strat and just murdered all these guys and gotten free experience, but I don't like fucking around with
strike
this mission.
One.
I really
that airstrike
don't.
Strike is closing in your position.
Yep.
You need to get to the evac point before it's too late.
We're going. We're just, you know, taking some selfies. I mean, we're not going to be able to see this place very much more. It's about to no longer exist. All right, Van Dorn, up
double
as
touch.
Far as you can. We're going to be done next turn.
On it.
All right.
Overwatch. On
Rev,
my way.
Move up. Overwatch.
I feel, Commander.
Hrothgar.
Location confirmed.
Move all the way up. Neith. All the way up. And I think it's all over but the Kryon for the sectoid, or the sectoids, the Chrysalids. Yep, we know.
Hey, do you hear something?
Terrifying alien horrors. We're hearing terrifying alien horrors that way. Alright, everybody into the evac. This party is over. Marines, we are leaving.
Affirmative.
Do party in the drop zone. Everyone's invited. Except the Chrysalids. No Chrysalids allowed.
Roger that.
Alright. And fireworks. Good night, nurse. Alright. No operatives lost. 34 aliens killed. That was Operation Forgotten Giant. A little bit dicey, but I think that that went well. I think the only person headed to the med bay is Hrothgar due to a unlucky thin man shot. Yeah, so I don't know if I would say that we saved Newfoundland, but we definitely removed their chrysalid problem. We're kind of like a really, really obscene version of Terminix or the Orkin Man or something like that. But yeah, nuke it from orbit. It's the only way to be sure. And back to base. Alrighty, well, Hrothgar is out for a month, but Hrothgar has also been promoted for her trouble. So, Sergeant Hrothgar, let's see, Ranger, Will to Survive, I might go Will to Survive. I'll have to look up what's best for a Bullet Wizard build. It's not Executioner because, you know, we're doing a lot of suppressing. It may be Will to Survive, just because, let's see, Will to Survive, ready for anything? Unit automatically enters Overwatch, maybe. Danger Zone, that's the important one. And then Mayhem. I'm thinking Will to Survive for a little bit of damage reduction. That'll help out with not getting massive wound timers. Because we'll have a little bit extra defense. And TS Moth. Let's see. We could do Suppression. We could do Ranger for the just all-out damage. Deadeye, not a bad idea for the aim against flying targets, but I already did that for an Overwatch, but I've been taking Deadeye on everybody. I'm tempted to do just like Ranger or something to just increase the damage potential. We will have to take a look. And, Josie the Rev. Lance Corporal Josie the Rev. I will have to speak with the Rev and find out what the real Rev wants for a nickname. But, I mean, the Rev is kind of all you need. However, we are going to be taking Snapshot on the Rev. I could go Rapid Reaction, and I could be building a an Overwatchy Rocketeer, but The method to my madness here is I want to try out, excuse me for yawning, I want to try out a rocketeer who can move and shoot. Sort of like a danger close rocketeer. Might be a terrible idea, but I want to try it. Maybe we'll take snapshot. Oh, and one other thing with the rev. I promised I would do this.
We will be in touch, Commander.
I'm sure you will be. Let's look at the soldiers. Let's look at our, let's see. Van Dorn's out for 8 days. Sean Devlin's out for 6. And Neith is out for 8. That's okay. We knew those were coming. However, the Rev... I have to do this on camera. It's entirely necessary. Nope, I don't want armor deco. I want hair helmet. Anybody who knows the Rev in real life knows why I'm doing this. If you don't know the Rev in real life, you should. But the Rev has to have the fedora. Just has to. One of the few that will get the fedora. Because I actually don't really like the fedora. Okay, so we have a pile of money. We're going to get a satellite in 6 days. We've got 3 laser rifles coming. We got a shiv coming. We got laser carbines. Auto lasers. I do not want to buy another interceptor yet. I don't want to do that yet because when that satellite goes up, I get the continent bonus. So I think we just scan for a moment. Whoop!
Commander, our intelligence sources indicate that a previously unknown organization is attempting to undermine XCOM field operations.
Those bastards!
We believe this group harbors some misguided sympathies for the invaders, and is intent on acquiring alien technology and artifacts critical to your efforts. Early reports indicate this organization calls itself
the Illuminati. Exalt.
We trust you will isolate the source of this new threat and eliminate it.
Command the face.
The Council has provided some additional resources to help us deal with these traitors. We can begin scanning for additional Exalt cell locations and launch covert operations to disrupt their activity via the Situation Room.
I was hoping for taquitos. Okay. I'm a terrible person who doesn't shut up. And Exalt took some of our money. Well, I'm actually surprised that they didn't show up until now. So Exalt sabotaged us and took $122. It's a good thing that we just got paid. The Exalt cell is exposed, but we'll go into hiding soon. Go to the Situation Room! Keys to global covert operations. Alrighty, so... at least they didn't increase panic. Alright, so we have an Exalt cell that we need to launch a covert operation against. We will also now need to start scanning for these guys. For those of you who don't know, Exalt is sort of like the extra human opposing force that we have to deal with. They're basically like the Illuminati, but, you know, they try not to be the Illuminati. We're not going to send Pixie Dust. Who we got? It's either going to be Montgomery, or I can't send Sarah Ivy. Sarah Ivy is going to be our agent. I'm going to groom Sarah Ivy to be the covert operative.
The engineering team
good health, great move, goodwill, and I'm building her talent spec around it. But for now, we are going to send Corporal Montgomery Payson. Generally, you want to send assaults on these. You'll see why when we get there. So Montgomery and his fantastic mustache. This is actually the first time we've gotten to see Montgomery. And there's something that I have to do. Very important that I do this before we go on the covert operation. Yes, I'm going to start slowly customizing people. Just for this, I want you all to know Montgomery is bald. I'm keeping the fantastic mustache, but Montgomery needs to be bald. Anybody who knows who Montgomery is knows why Montgomery needs to be bald. Alright. Let's see. Soldier list. Smash Montgomery. He is quite smashing, isn't he? He needs a martini and a suit. Alright, loadout. We are going to give Montgomery a battle scanner. Can we to give Montgomery a battle scanner. Yes, we can. We will soon lose the ability to give Montgomery a battle scanner, because if I update Beta 15E again, we will lose that ability. I'm also going to give Montgomery an alloy plate, because you can't wear armor on this mission, and I don't want to lose Montgomery to, like, a bonehead move. So, we will send Montgomery to South Africa.
To disrupt Exalt Cell in South Africa.
Excellent. Alright. So that'll be a few days. Let's see, when does the covert operation happen? 6 days. So at the same time that we get the satellite, we get the covert operation, we'll make a little bit of money, we'll be able to put a new bird in the air. It'll be great. In fact, do I want to start building... I think I want to start building a couple more phalanx armors. Thinking like two of them. Yeah, two phalanx armors. We're going to need a float soon anyway. And since we are now doing exalt things, let's do... I don't want that many. Let's do a couple of laser pistols. I could do a heater. We'll stick with the laser pistol for now. And we need an alloy plating, right? Yeah, let's do one extra alloy plating. Just for the extra float. I know that just spent most of our money, but, you know, these things happen.
Contact detected.
We have a low raider. Low raider is probably scouting. Alright. Let's send up some avalanche missiles. Let's see, we got Meteor back in 3 days. Let's go unbalanced. Let's at least harass him a little bit.
We have eyes on the bandit.
Alright. Hit him! Come on! There we go. Get out of there, get out of there. Van Dorn's flying the airplane! Alright, are you making right turns, or are you, like, going somewhere to land? He's flying pretty slow. Nope, that's a right angle turn. Okay. We go up with the avalanche missiles. Let's see, laser's down for 13 days. Let's go up balance and see what we can do with lunchbox. I don't want to blow all my birds on this one guy, but I want to try to at least hit him a few more times. Come on, come on! Ah! And one more time. Get out of there. Alright. I think that's enough damage to mess up his mission. Savage is back! We have another raider. All I've got is stingrays. Okay. We can't do anything about this one.
Contact detected.
This one, however, we could do something about. Go get him, Wolfram. This is why we didn't send these guys up after that guy.
Engaging bogey.
Take him out. Come on. We did research on fighters. We should be able to get this guy. Come on. One more. One more.
Lost.
Ugh. Not good.
Contact detected.
Well, let's try and finish him off with Lenny. Come on, Lenny. Come on, Lenny. Take him out.
Commander, by ignoring these UFO contacts, we're putting our entire satellite network at risk.
There we go. No damage. Alien crash site. And that's good. We can take that alien crash site because we're going to get a little bit more resources off of this one than normal. That will be our next mission. Alrighty. So, Newfoundland was a success. I'm not going to lie, I might not be able to get the episodes up in time, because I am kind of recording these at the last minute. But you'll know that or not know that by this time later. By the time you see this, they'll both already have been uploaded. Anyway, I don't know why I'm ranting. I record these before I upload them, and I'm John Madden. Welcome to Jackass. If you like this episode, please click like. If you would like to be notified of the next episode, please consider subscribing to the channel. I have been Mark Zero. I am very tired. I am going to go get some sleep. I will see you next time.